So I finally got the Skype Wi-Fi Netgear phone. Let's see what it can do. It's kind of small, like a normal cell phone. There we go. Let's start it up. Oh, Netgear. Good. Oh, the sun. Let's hope it stays sunny in the Skype landscape. So basically, I just switched it on, and here we have the Skype logo with the slogan "The whole world can call for free," or is it talk for free? Whatever. Now it's searching for a network and it's joining the nearest wireless network, which is in my place. It's an open network. Okay, now let's see what this is. Now it's asking me to log on. I'm gonna sign into Skype. And I have to type my logon name. Let's do that. So the typing pad is also kind of an interesting thing. You can easily type in any character without any problem. Okay, good to know. So it's usable URL. Okay. Now the password. No, I'm not showing you. And now it's asking me if it wants to save it. Yes. So let's log on to it. It's signing in. So it got connected to the Wi-Fi. It's an open Wi-Fi. So this is the limitation of this phone. It will only work in these type of wireless internets. From the moment that you have a browser-based logon to do, which is basically the case on many public Wi-Fi networks, then you are in trouble. But there we have the sound. But Boingo is going to change something, providing you global connectivity based on your Skype account. At least that's what I was told, and that's what I understand. So now we are logged on to Skype. So let's make a call to a person. There we go, calling him. Oh, and now it tells me wait a few minutes for contacts to download before placing a call. Okay, so be it. And let's wait a few minutes.